Hi students, all of you, good morning. Welcome to the class. In today's class, we are going to discuss the topic polymers. Here, polymer is a word that is containing two subwords. The first one is poly. Poly means many. Second subword, mer. Mer means unit. So polymers means a large molecule that is containing so many number of units. Once again, polymer means a large molecule that is containing so many number of units. Right. What is the exact definition of polymer? Polymer is defined as a large molecule that is known as a macromolecule having high molecular mass ranging between 10 power 3 to 10 power 7 unified mass. U means unified mass. In the first PSC you studied atomic structure. There you know that to measure the mass of any atom we use the word unified mass. So here U stands for unified mass. So once again the definition, polymer defined as a large molecule or a macromolecule having high molecular mass ranging between 10 power 3 to 10 power unified mass formed by the reaction of simple molecules of same type or simple molecules of different type. So this is the definition of a polymer. And coming to the example, in our regular life we are going through polythene cover. Example, here I am writing the example polythene. This is an example of polymer. It is containing two words. One is the poly and the second one is ethene. What is meant by ethene? CH2 double bond CH2. This is known as ethene. And how many they are taken? Many. Many means poly. Poly is taken as N. So when N molecules of ethene is undergoing a reaction, then that is going to give a large molecule or that is going to give a macromolecule. That macromolecule obtained is called as polythene. Right? I'm going to write the reaction. Formation of polythene. How the polythene is going to be formed? So to get the polythene, what we require? Ethene. How many molecules of ethene is taken? N molecules of ethene is taken. Ethene means CH2, double bond CH2. This is the ethene or ethylene. Common name is ethylene. When it is undergoing a reaction, first of all, double bond is there between carbon and carbon. Between carbon and carbon, double bond is there means it is unsaturated. So it is an example of unsaturated compound. All of you know that unsaturated compounds readily undergo addition reactions. So here, N molecules of ethene is undergoing addition reaction. During the addition reaction, pi bond is going to be broken. When a pi bond is going to be broken, two sigma bonds are going to be formed. Now I am writing CH2. Pi bond is going to be broken, then it is going to have only sigma bond. Again, CH2. How many times these units are repeated? These units are repeated N times. Here, when a pi bond is broken, how many sigma bonds are going to be formed? Two sigma bonds are going to be formed. This is a one new sigma bond. This is a second new sigma bond. So two new sigma bonds are formed. And these units are going to be repeated N times. These units are going to be repeated N times. Then we are going to write it as single bond CH2, single bond CH2 taken N times. Now this is known as polythene. So here what we are taking? We are taking N molecules of ethene. When ethene is undergoing addition reaction, then it is going to give the polythene. And this reaction is indicating that it's an addition reaction means the polymer formed is an example of which type of polymer? Addition polymer. So in the CET, the bit will be asked like this: among the following, which one is an example of addition polymer? Once again, the question: among the following, which one is an example of addition polymer? So you can understand the formation of addition polymer very simply. To undergo addition reaction, what is required? Unsaturation in a molecule is required, and here this molecule is called as monomer. Here this is called as polymer. So a polymer is obtained from the simple molecules. That simple molecules which are going to give the polymer, that simple molecules are called as monomers. So now we can say that polyethylene is an example of polymer, and the monomer units of the polyethylene are, what are the monomer units of polyethylene? Text me your answer. What are the monomer units of polyethylene? Right, correct. So what are the monomer units of polyethylene? Ethene is the monomer unit of polyethylene. What is meant by monomer? How can we define a monomer? What is a monomer? Monomer is defined as the simple repeating structural units. The simple repeating structural units of a polymer. Once again, the simple repeating structural units of a polymer are called as monomers. So polyethylene is the polymer, and its monomer units are ethene units. And ethene, being an unsaturated monomer, the unsaturated monomers always gives a polymer. That polymer is going to be a addition polymer, and this process is called as polymerization. Now the question again: what is meant by polymerization? The formation of a polymer from its monomer units is called as polymerization. And polymers are also known as macromolecules. Please remember this one. Polymers are also known as macromolecules. Right. This is about formation of a polyethylene. That is an example of addition polymer. Just tell me, polyethylene is obtained from how many types of monomer units? Polyethylene is obtained from how many types of monomer units? Polyethylene is obtained from one type of monomer unit. What is that one? What is that one? Polyethylene is obtained from one type of monomer units. What is that one? Yes, polyethylene. This is the polyethylene. That polyethylene is obtained from ethene. So here only one type of monomer unit is present. Now this polymer is called as homopolymer. Now the question again arises: what is meant by a homopolymer? How can we understand a homopolymer? Homopolymer means if any polymer obtained from only one type of monomer units. Once again, the definition: what is meant by a homopolymer? If any polymer obtained from only one type of monomer units, such polymers are called as homopolymers. Okay, so this is an example of what is polythene is an example of addition polymer, and polythene is an example of homopolymer. Right. I'm going to move to one more example. PVC. PVC. Polyvinyl chloride. PVC. Polyvinyl chloride. We are using the plastic pipes. Plastic pipes. Nothing but PVC pipes. Plastic pipes. That the PVC pipes we are using. PVC. PVC means polyvinyl chloride. Again, here two words are there. One is poly, second one is vinyl chloride. Vinyl chloride. Yes, poly means many. Many means n times. Vinyl. What is the vinyl group? What is the vinyl group? CH2 double bond, CH single bond is called as vinyl group. Bonded with chlorine. So this is a compound called as vinyl chloride. Yes, my dear students, tell me whether vinyl chloride is an example of saturated compound or unsaturated compound. Whether vinyl chloride is an example of saturated compound or unsaturated compound. Whether vinyl chloride is an example of saturated or unsaturated compound. Yes, correct. Vinyl chloride is an example of unsaturated compound, and it is an unsaturated monomer. Monomer. Now, this is going to undergo polymerization. Which type of polymerization? Addition polymerization. Which type of polymerization it is? Addition polymerization. Why it is addition polymerization? Why this reaction is an example of addition polymerization? Can anybody say why this reaction is an example of addition polymerization? Why? Because means the monomer unit is vinyl chloride, and that is an example of unsaturated compound. Unsaturated compounds readily undergoes addition reactions. So whenever an addition reaction is going to happen, the pi bond is going to be broken. Between the carbon and carbon, here is a pi bond. When a pi bond is going to be broken, two new sigma bonds are going to be formed. Then this compound is written as CH2. Double bond becomes single bond. CH2. Double bond becomes as single bond CH. And this CH is bonded with. CH is bonded with chlorine. Now, the pi bond is going to be broken to give two new sigma bonds. One sigma bond at this carbon, second sigma bond at this carbon, and these units are going to be repeated. How many times? These units are going to be repeated n times. Now, this is known as poly. Taken n times means poly, and it is coming from vinyl chloride. Polyvinyl chloride. Simply it is called as PVC. Yes, my dear students, tell me PVC is an example of which type of polymer? PVC is an example of which type of polymer? PVC is an example of addition polymer. Once again, PVC is an example of addition polymer. Why? Because means PVC is obtained from vinyl chloride, where vinyl chloride is a monomer. Which type of monomer it is? Unsaturated monomer. So, if any polymer which is obtained from unsaturated monomer, such polymers are called as, such polymers are called as addition polymers. So we can also say that PVC is an example of addition polymer, right? Yes, text me. PVC, whether it is a homopolymer or not. PVC, whether it is a homopolymer or not. Whether PVC is an example of homopolymer or not. Yes, homopolymer. Why? Because means PVC is obtained from monomer. How many types of monomers are present here? How many types of monomers are present here? One type of monomer is present. Only CH2 double bond, CH single bond Cl. That is vinyl chloride is only present. Only one type of monomer is present. So if any polymer which is obtained from only one type of monomer, such polymer is called as, such polymer is called as, here I am going to write, such polymer is called as homopolymer. Yes, tell me now, what is meant by a homopolymer? How can we understand a homopolymer? What is the definition of homopolymer? If any polymer is obtained from only one type of monomer units. Once again, if any polymer which is obtained from only one type of monomer units, such polymer is called as homopolymer. So here I'm going to say about homopolymer. Homopolymer contain how many types of monomer units? Homopolymer contain only one type of homopolymer contain only one type of monomer units. Homopolymers contain only one type of monomer units. Example for homopolymers are, what are the examples of homopolymer? Polyethylene is an example of homopolymer. PVC is an example of homopolymer. And one more example for homopolymer, polyacrylonitrile. Acrylonitrile, what is meant by acrylonitrile? One more example for homopolymer, polyacrylonitrile. Poly means N, acrylonitrile. Acrylonitrile is nothing but vinyl cyanide. Vinyl cyanide, this is the acrylonitrile. How many times it is? N times it is. So when this compound, what is the compound? Vinyl cyanide or acrylonitrile. When it is undergoing polymerization, then it is going to give polyacrylonitrile. Then the polyacrylonitrile is represented as, just simply remove this pi bond and take sigma bond and sigma bond here, CN here. How many times it is going to be repeated? N times. So this is an example of polyacrylonitrile. That is also an example of homopolymer. So all the homopolymers are having only one type of monomer units, right? Okay, now it is about copolymers. Copolymers. What are meant by copolymers? CO, co. Copolymers. Yes, please stay on the line. I have to take the attendance first. My dear students, after the completion of the class, I'm going to send you the PDF. Already I written the notes. I'm going to send the PDF. Please read the PDF, whatever I'm going to send to you. You can understand the classes very easily. Then practice the MCQs from your material. I request you all please practice MCQs from your material. Just stay online. This chapter is very, very easiest chapter. Very, very, very easiest chapter. Please don't neglect. Because some students are not practicing at your homes. You are very lazy at your homes. I think so, you are very lazy at your homes. Because yesterday the exam was conducted, most of the students are written very well, but the expected students are not written very well. Anyhow, coming to the point, copolymers. Copolymers means, directly I'm going to the example. The example is Biona S. Here, Biona S is a copolymer. Of course, any polymer that contain monomers. Here, Biona S is a polymer that is going to contain two monomers. First monomer is 1,3 butadiene. 1,3 butadiene. 1,3 butadiene. How it is represented? CH2, double bond CH, single bond CH, double bond CH2. This is the 1,3 butadiene. First carbon having double bond, third carbon having double bond. So the compound is named as 1,3 butadiene. That is the one of the monomer. And the second monomer is here. Yes stands for styrene. Yes stands for styrene. What is the styrene? Styrene means again CH2 double bond CH single bond, but here the group is C6H5. That is the styrene or styrene or styrene. So when we are going to consider Biona S, that is containing monomers. How many monomers are present in Biona S? Two different types of monomers are present. Two different types of monomers are present in a polymer. Then that is an example of copolymer. Yes. How can we represent Biona S? So first of all, I'm going to take n moles of 1,3 butadiene. N moles of 1,3 butadiene. CH2 double bond, CH single bond, CH double bond, CH2. This is 1,3 butadiene. This is one of the monomer. Of course, it is which type of monomer? Unsaturated monomer, right? And the second monomer is n moles of styrene or styrene. What is the formula of styrene or styrene? Styrene is represented as CH2 double bond CH single bond C6H5. This is the styrene or styrene. Okay. Styrene is also an example of unsaturated monomer. Yes, my dear students, please tell me which type of polymerization reaction will take place. Which type of polymerization reaction will take place? Which type of polymerization reaction will take place? Addition polymerization. Once again, addition polymerization. Why addition polymerization? Why because means the monomers. If we see the monomers, first monomer is 1,3 butadiene. That is unsaturated monomer. Second monomer is styrene. That is also unsaturated monomer. So whenever unsaturated monomers are undergoing a reaction to give the polymer, then the obtained polymer is an example of addition polymer, and the process is called as addition polymerization. The obtained polymer, that is going to be an example of addition polymer, and the process is called as addition polymerization. So here the process is called as addition polymerization. Addition polymerization. Now we have to write the addition product. How can we write the addition products? To write the addition products, first of all, I am going to consider first monomer. I am going to consider the first monomer, and I am going to remove this pi bond. When the pi bond is going to be removed, there is only a sigma bond. CH2, single bond, CH. Here, single bond becomes double bond, CH. Double bond becomes single bond, CH2. Here, one new sigma bond is going to be formed. And this is going to be reacted with this one. Here, what is there? CH2. This is the one, CH2. Double bond becomes single bond, CH. And the CH is bonded with C6H5. And a new sigma bond is formed again. And these units are repeated n times. So now this polymer formed is called as Buna S. S stands for styrene. What is meant by styrene? CH2, double bond, CH, single bond, C6H5, that is called as styrene. Now, tell me, this is the Buna S, whether it is an example of addition polymer or not. Whether Buna S is an example of addition polymer or not. Yes, Buna S is an example of addition polymer. Why? Because means Buna S is obtained from the monomers. Which type of monomers? 1,3 betadiene is unsaturated monomer. Styrene is also unsaturated monomer. So whenever a polymer is obtained from unsaturated monomers, such polymers are called as addition polymers. Then we can say that Buna S is an example of addition polymer. But Buna S is not an example of homopolymer. Once again, Buna S is not an example of homopolymer. Why Buna S is not an example of homopolymer? Why the Buna S is not an example of homopolymer? Right, correct. It is containing two different types of, you have to say that, not two types of, two different types of monomers are there. First monomer is 1,3 betadiene. This is the one. Second monomer is styrene. This is the one. So whenever two different types of monomers are undergoing polymerization, then the obtained polymer is called as a copolymer. So now you can say that Buna S is an example of addition polymer, as well as Buna S is an example of copolymer. And what are the monomer units of Buna S? First monomer unit is 1,3 butadiene. Second monomer is styrene. Right, one more example. Buna N. Example for copolymerization. Example for copolymerization. Buna N. Buna S and Buna N. Now it is Buna N. Buna N contain again
two different types of monomers, and the monomers are the first monomer is same. What is the same? The first monomer is same. What is the name? 1,3 butadiene. This is the thing, common thing. 1,3 butadiene is common
both in Buna N and Buna S. We are going to take N molecules of 1,3 butadiene reacting with N molecules of N, capital N. N stands for nitrile. Here, which nitrile we are going to take? CH2 double bond, CH single bond, nitrile. Nitrile means cyanide, single bond CN, or single bond C, triple bond N, cyanide. Cyanides are called as nitriles. So here we are taking vinyl cyanide. CH2 double bond, CH single bond. This group is called as vinyl. CN is called as cyanide. Vinyl cyanide, otherwise it is also called as acrylonitrile. So how many types of monomers are present here? Two different types of monomers are present here when these two are undergoing polymerization. Which type of polymerization will take place? Which type of polymerization will take place? Which type of polymerization will take place? Yes, addition polymerization will take place. Then I can write it as by removing the pi bond. Here, pi bond is going to be removed. Here, a pi bond is going to be formed. Here, a pi bond is going to be removed. Now, two new sigma bonds. This is the first sigma bond, new. This is the second sigma bond, new. And this is going to react with this one. And here, a pi bond is going to be removed. The pi bond is going to be removed. And this CN is represented at the bottom, CN. And again, a new sigma bond. So this is the unit going to be repeated how many times? N times. Here N stands for number, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. That is the numbers, natural numbers. So this polymer is called as Buna N. Now tell me, Buna N is an example of which type of polymer? Buna N is an example of which type of polymer? Yes, Buna N is an example of addition polymer, because the monomers are unsaturated. The two monomers are unsaturated. Hence, Buna N is an example of addition polymer. And Buna N is containing two different types of monomer units. Hence, Buna N is an example of copolymer. Right, in the next class, we will discuss the remaining things. Today, I'm going to send you the PDF. Please read the PDF till the end. Just text me whether the class is understood or not. Text me whether the class is understood or not. Don't text S. If it is understood, text me as understood, sir.